Hello and welcome back. I've changed the field of view from 85 to 90 since the last video. So I'll see how that goes. Might have to adjust my sensitivity of the mouse. It feels quite... That's a bit better. I'm quite a low sensitivity player when it comes to most games. I was just trying to remember how that opened, and I thought it might be if you collect the other explosive shotgun shells, but obviously it was this. Yeah, that got him. Level 3 key. That water really looks good, what they've done to it. Can't get into this for the moment. Is that the... looks like the warp portal, I think.
Warp portal activated.
Right. Isn't that where I fight some of the Primogen's elite guards or something? I can't quite remember. Suppose I should start using the shotgun. But then again, if you keep missing, it's not a good idea. Oh, that's the tech bow. Right, okay, I'll get that in a moment. Can't quite remember how you get onto there, but I know I have done it before. Being a bit loose with my shots at the moment. Some are hitting, but some definitely aren't. And the frame rate is all over the place at the moment. better. Just grab some pistol ammo. Right, I'm gonna go back and go to the warp portal before I enter this portal. I think that's just another do you want ammo or health portal. Just love the charm in this game of all the little sounds that you hear in the background. I think it's one of the best games ever for that. Now, can you jump from here to there to get over there? I'm assuming that no, you can't. You have to go from there to there. Because you can't jump all that far in this game. It's not really that high, not really that far. Okay, so let's. How do you use that again? Do you. Okay, that's the zoom function then. Right. Oh! I won't complain about that. Guys up there to give you practice with the tech bow, of course, but I'm quite happy using the pistol at the moment. Are they tech arrows or are they just plain arrows? Plain arrows, I think. Perhaps I'll try one from here just to see. No, I'm going backwards. Let's try, just try the standard arrows. They can take quite a few arrows to the body, if I remember rightly. But that's taking care of him anyway. So the blue flight ones appear to be tech arrows. Yeah, I think I got him with one shot there, out there. That was intentional, but it was lucky as well. I remember these sort of platforms you get on and you can have various results from walking onto them. And I thought this was a really great feature of the game. But I haven't got the. Is it. Do you need a feather or something to go on there? It's hard to remember all those years ago now. I half expected to be able to jump then, but. Clearly not. I guess I come back to here later on then when I've got. Sufficient equipment to enable me to do it. So for now, I think I'll just go back and step into the warp portal. Since that appears to be the next logical step. Would be nice to get some more pistol ammunition first, though, so I'll just nip back and grab some of that. I like the way how enemies are still present when you come back quite some time later. I do like that in games, but you don't see it all that often, really. No, I was wrong. It's alright, I was getting confused. I should be going to the warp portal. What am I doing? Not thinking straight at the moment. I like that sun up there. It's quite nicely done.
Chamber, a holy place that evil cannot enter. Activating the warp portals opens gateways to these ancient sanctuaries. Your quest will require you to locate 5 sacred talismans. The talismans will grant you immunity from certain types of danger and allow you access to new areas that must be explored. The spirits that watch over these chambers will require an offering of a mystical evil feather before a talisman can be secured. There are 5 talismans and 5 eagle feathers that must be found as your quest unfolds.
So I thought when I jumped into the portal that I'd end up fighting one of the some of the Primogen's men, but clearly it's to learn about the. These are eagle feathers. So I take it there's nothing to collect in it, it's just an introduction to how that mechanic works. And you've respawned. No, I've gone back. Right, so now I'm going into this one. I've already got the tech bow, so... Alright, yeah, you can't get more than 10 arrows anyway. Right, I'm out of pistol ammunition now. There's probably some back through that portal, but it's not worth. It's not quite worth going through all of that just to get one pistol mag. And there's some there. I think this was what was used in the cutscene when we were introduced to the port of Adia at the beginning of the game. Right, so that comes in fire arrows. It's quite a beautiful city, really. Certainly quite enchanting and quite thought-provoking. So that's 7 lives now. What happens if you destroy these? Oh, you can't anyway. If I remember rightly, if you walk through there, you step into a portal. But it's just that one that's open, so I have to go through it. What was that? Oh yeah, I remember this bit. I keep expecting to see a creature around here somewhere, but evidently not. Or not yet. If anyone finds this field of view a little bit too fisheye, let me know and I'll alter it. I'm even beginning to wonder if I should drop it down slightly myself, but I'll give it a bit longer yet. I don't need the shells. That looks to be pistol ammunition. And oh, it's that key. Right, so I don't think you can have more than 10 explosive rounds. Well, I've never seen something roll up a hill, so that's quite that's a new one on me. That was pretty cool. Oh, wow, that was a bit lucky. I thought there was something behind this door, but I couldn't be sure of it. But just happened to get the got the right level with the crosshair. Whoops. Fortunately, those ones don't seem to be too tough. Is that an ultra health or something like that up there, the orange one? I think there's a yellow one as well. Maybe even a green one, I can't remember, it's been so long ago. That's an excuse I'll be using quite a bit. Have already used quite a bit. Right, I can hear a child crying in the distance. Yeah, I don't seem to have much trouble with these ones. Oh, you can destroy those, right, okay. I guess it's no point going up there to get that because my health's too high, but just want to check to make sure there's nothing else there. Nothing hidden away. Ah, there is. Good time to notice a pistol mag. I think I'll just try turning the anti-aliasing down and to FX AA to boost the frame rate a bit. Hopefully that will help. I don't know whether you have to restart the game or whether it applies instantly, but bit early to say, but it does feel quite smooth. Had to take him down pretty quick. It could be for that one, I guess. I think that extends the ladder outside this house. No? Obviously opens up this then. I think that does the ladder. Yes. Grab the key. Crafty, I can't see him. I expect he's gone back into a chamber in there somewhere. I guess the next thing to do is just to jump through here. I remember this bit being quite tricky last time, but that was with the controller, so I'll just try the pistol to start with. They can take quite a few hits. Quite like how the blood splatters over various objects, a bit like in Stalker or any game for that matter, where they've applied it not just to the one surface. Looks quite good. Short and to the point. I might just try an explosive shell just to see how it fares at reasonable range. Probably too far away to make maximum effect of it. Oh no, it did kill him. I'm surprised. Perhaps a non-explosive one wouldn't have achieved that. What's in here? Is it just... oh, it's just a checkpoint station. So if I just go into it and come out of it, does it give me a save automatically, regardless of what I do?
Greetings, Turok. How may I assist you?
Quick warp. Not specifically sure what that does, although I can hazard a guess. But I think I'll just come out of it. Oh, of course, I forget that it... gives you respawning enemies to a limited extent.